Hello everybody, let's understand how to implement logistic regression using TensorFlow. Just a brief background about logistic regression. What we try to do here is we basically try to create a decision boundary which tries to separate data into classes. Can be two, can be more than that. Okay, let's understand how to implement this using TensorFlow. And a lot of things are similar to what we have seen in linear regression apart from cost function. We will see why. Okay, let's get started. Okay, so these are the same imports that we have done earlier as well. One new thing that we are doing is we are just creating a session directly without using with session. Okay, so that the entire code whatever right here becomes part of this session. And of course, that's not a great best practice, but we're getting it started with that. We are using cancer data from scikit-learn. Scikit-learn data sets, we are using breast cancer data. This data has 30 columns and 569 rows, as you can see here. Okay, all of them are numerical columns, numerical data. Okay, and what is the target information? Target information, as you can see here, is basically 0 and 1. Okay, that means 0 means no cancer, 1 means cancer. Okay, what we'll try to do, we'll try to implement a logistic regression using TensorFlow to do the prediction. Linear logistic regression is meant for classification, and this is a perfect problem for classification. These are the features of the data. Of course, in this case for us, we are using all the data, implementing basic logistic regression. So these are all the features part of it. First thing that we do is we basically can divide your data into train and test. As we understand, to validate a model is a very significant step. Okay. So whatever data we have, we are breaking down into train data and test data. 80-20 is the ratio. And these are the indices which belong to test data. And to print the train data indices, these are the ones. Okay, highly randomized. So from the indices, we get the data, which is train data, test data, target information. So you can see here, X is feature data, Y is target information, and X will consist 30 columns, Y will be one column, as the target can be 0 and 1, but feature data will be all the values, all the columns that we have seen above these columns. Okay, of course, all of them are numbers at this point. Then what will be the number of what will be the vector size of A in this case? Since there are 30 columns, we'll make A as row vector of 30. Okay, so that's what you see here. This is the vector size of A, 30, 1, and this is B again. B is bias or intercept in this case. Okay, so this is one parameter. This is important because bias or the intercept, this is some parameter which is agnostic of the featured information. Okay. So what are you doing here? We are creating a module. Okay, TF add, TF matmul, MX plus C, that is what we are trying to implement over here. This is one significant difference here, the loss function. Okay, loss function, we are using TF dot NN dot sigmoid cross entropy. What is sigmoid? Okay, if you pass a value X to a linear regression function, it will generate a continuous value. But for logistic regression, it is a classification algorithm. The output should be between either 0 or 1 in case of biclassification. Okay. In case of more than that classes, 0 and 1 will be divided. So we using sigmoid function, whatever number is it converts your data between 0 and 1. It never reaches 0, it never reaches 1. It is tends to 0 and tends to 1. Okay, that is your loss function. So how is it happening? So whatever model output is there, okay, you are passing it to sigmoid function and you are doing a reduced mean of it. Okay, so this is what you are doing for calculating the loss. Okay, then we need to initialize the global variables, whatever we have been creating, like A and B in this case, and this is how we are doing. This is a little different from what we did earlier, just to cover all the aspects. And then you are doing a session.run init to initialize the global variables. This is the gradient, this is an optimizer object we are creating. This is the learning rate, and this is the final object which is dependent on the entire graph. Okay, this is a gradient descent optimizer, minimize the loss. Okay, now we need to see how to do prediction also using this. So that is what TF sigmoid model output. So model output will be some continuous value. If you pass this to sigmoid, it will convert it between 0 and 1 and it will round it. That means if it is 0.3, it will round it up to 0. If it is 0.7, it will round it to 1. Okay, this is the prediction. So whatever data you pass, if the formula generates you some data, you pass it to sigmoid function and you round off it, you'll get precisely whether it is 0 or 1, every iterable code. Okay. Then the next thing that you are doing here, you are doing a TF equal prediction and target. Okay, what does it mean? It will return you a vector for which this prediction is equal to target, and you are doing a reduced mean out of it. So what this entire thing is required to find accuracy. Whenever the actual data target is equal to the predicted target, you will say mark that one, others will be zero. So you will have a vector of zeros and one. If you do reduce mean of this data, you will basically end up with how accurate is the algorithm in the scale of 0 and 1. Right? Okay. Let's proceed further. Okay. So now we have three lists we are creating. One is for loss vector, one is for train accuracy, one is for test accuracy. Just to store all this information.
Yeah. So let's now see the iteration. Okay. The total number of iteration that is happening here is 1000 in this case. Okay. So the number of times the batch will be executed is 1000. Okay. So here we are first choosing the batch size of data from the entire lot. That's what you are doing here. You are doing session.run here. This is train step is the object which executes the entire graph. The feed dictionary, we are passing the placeholder values here. Okay, random max and random value. This is the data that we are passing here. Then you have temp loss. We are calculating the loss function. This is temporal loss and appending it in the loss vector. We are calculating temp loss for test data as well, putting it in the list temp accuracy. Okay, so this, after this 1000 iteration have run, what will happen, it will, the train accuracy and test accuracy will hold the accuracy parameters at every stage. Okay, so we saw a lot of similarity between linear regression and this case, right? And if you try to print the accuracy, so we are seeing the accuracy like this. Okay, and we plot it, if you plot a graph, it will, the accuracy will be shrinking towards zero, as you can see the data here. Okay, so we now saw that, you know, how logistic regression is implemented, and with the same technique as we use for linear regression, we can see the loss converging. Okay, that's all for today. Thank you.